Hello, welcome again. We are solving some conventional questions of power plant. The topic is combined gas and steam power plant. Question number 35 from Civil Services, main question 14 is: in a combined gas turbine steam turbine plant, the exhaust from GT is used to heat steam in boiler, at which a further supply of fuel is burned in the gas. Pressure ratio of GT is 8. Inlet air temperature is 15 degrees Celsius. Maximum cycle temperature is 800 degrees Celsius. Combustion in boiler increases the gas temperature to 800 degrees Celsius and gas leaves the boiler at 800 degrees Celsius. The steam inlet in steam turbine is at 60 bar and 600 degrees Celsius. H is equal to 3656.2 kilojoules per kilogram. S is equal to 7.166 kilojoules per kilogram per degree Kelvin. And the condenser pressure is 0.05 bar. HF is equal to 137.8 kilojoule per kilogram. HFG is equal to 2423.8 kilojoule per kilogram. SF is equal to 0.476 kilojoule per kilogram, and SFG is equal to 7.92 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin. Calculate flow rate of air and steam required for total power output of 190 megawatt and overall efficiency of combined plant. Assume that processes are ideal, but is the overall air fuel ratio. Assume CPG is equal to 1.11 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin and CPL is equal to 1.05 kilojoule per kilogram per degree Kelvin, and gamma for gas and air as 1.33 and 1.4 respectively. Neglect flow rate of fuel on the air flow. Calorific value of fuel is 43.3 megajoule. So here first we will draw the combined gas and steam power cycle. So this is your combined gas and steam power cycle. So 1-2 is your compressor work. 1-2-3-4 is gas turbine cycle. 1-2 compressor work. 2-3 addition. 3-4 turbine work. And after 4 the gas has been heated to 0.48 before supplying to the steam. Okay. And then this enters the boiler and heats the steam and leaves at 100 degrees Celsius. And this 5, 6, 7, 8 is your steam cycle. And first of all, considering the gas turbine cycle and considering process 1, 2, T1 is your 15 degrees Celsius and pressure ratio is 8. So from this we can render up. As all the pressures are ideal and here there is only F, so we will use gamma A and find out T2. T3 is given, that is 1073 Kelvin. And again the process in turbine is also isentropic, so T3 by T4 will be equal to T3 by T4. Therefore gamma G minus gamma G, so gamma G minus 1 divided by gamma G. So putting the value of T3 by T4 and T3, you can find out T4. Okay, now this is the exhaust temperature of the steam turbine cycle. Okay, so now we consider this is the exhaust temperature of the gas turbine cycle. Now we consider steam cycle, that is 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, and these gases are heated up to 0.48. Okay, but the actual steam cycle is 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so we will consider first of all these 5, 6, 7, 8. Temperature at T5 is given, enthalpy at this temperature is enthalpy and entropy at this point is given, and entropy at 0.5 and entropy at 0.6 is equal because of isentropy process. Okay, and as we can see that here at 0.6 the steam is wet, so we will find the Dynard reaction by equating entropy. So this is entropy at 0.5 and these are the saturated liquid entropy. Entropy and this is the vapor entropy, vapor phase entropy. So we can find out X6 Dynard reaction, and then we can find out S6 and S7 is the enthalpy at enthalpy of saturated liquid at this pressure. And S7 and S8 are approximately same because we are neglecting pump work, so we are taking S7 is equal to S8. So we have found out enthalpy at every point. So now the gas is at 800 Celsius, is used to heat water, and it leaves the boiler at 100 degrees. So change in temperature of gases is 800 minus 100. Okay. And suppose mg is the mass of the gases that is used to heat the water, and ms is the mass of the steam that is used per second. So by equating heat, because heat is supplied from 5 to 7 or 5 to 8, okay. So we can find out by putting in Dalkey, then by putting the value of CpG, we can find out ms by mg. So that comes as 0.22. So mg is the total mass of gases entering in the that is used for heating the steam. Okay. So now we consider combustion in the gas turbine. Suppose MF1 is the fuel added in the gas turbine that is used to heat MGG. MGG means that is the gases flowing in the gas turbine. Okay. That is equal to mass of air plus mass of fuel added in the gas turbine. Okay. So now we know the calorific value, and these gases are increasing. This fuel is increasing the temperature of gases from 2 to 3. So by equating the heat of these two, or by heat balance, we can find out mg by ma, like this. First of all, we find out ma by mf1, and then we'll add and subtract ma and ma. Okay, so this will be your mgg. So if we reciprocate it, if we take it reciprocal, then it will be mg. We can find out mgg by ma is equal to 1.012. okay. So now if we consider the heat addition boiler, suppose mf2 be the fuel added in the boiler, and it is changing with the heat of the gases from changing the temperature of the gases from T4 to T4a, and total mass becomes mgg plus mg mf2. So likewise, we can find out, as in previous case, we can find out mg by mgg. Okay, so that comes as 1.02. Okay, now we have found out mgg by mg ma, and we have found out this mg by gg. So if we multiply these two, we can find out ma by mg. So ma by mg is 0.9818. So now the power drive is 190 into 10^6 watt, and net power drive is power drive by steam power plant, and power drive by gas turbine minus power consumed by compressor. We are neglecting pump work in steam turbine. So now this power drive in by the steam power plant is MSH5 minus HF, and this power drive in the gas turbine is MGG CPG T394, and the power consumption compressor is MA CP290. Now we have MA in terms of MG, we have MS in terms of MG, we have MG in terms of MG. So we can find out MG. MG is the mass of gases that is used to heat steam. Okay. So now we have already found out MS by MA, MG ratio from this we can find the MS, and that we can find the MA. Now the total fuel added is MG minus MA. Because this is the final mass of the gases, and this is the air, so this is the fuel added. So air fuel and air fuel ratio is ma by mf, so that is 55.515. And heat supplied is now because we have found out this mf, total mass of fuel, so we can find out total heat supplied mf in the cv, so that is 268027 kilowatt. And net power output is 190 kilowatts. So efficiency is 70.88%.